can tell by the sound of your voice if you're really in love with me. And you are. And you are. You know I can't lie. If I say to you, baby, I love you, then baby, I love you. Oh, and I do. Yes, I do. I do. Could it be that the faith you got never would save you? Well, baby, you better hold on tight. I'm the one who's been the world, all right. Ooh, I might. So when I use it night, just sleep back with a thought that you'll always be part of the world for me. And you dream that the stars up above at the end of the world will be more than we won't be.
Thank you. instituted in his word, we are commanded that we might hold it in awe. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord give you his perfect peace, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Button in the back.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to ask you to receive Miss.
Thank you. day. Alright. This is what I wrote this morning as far as a toast. As far as this was what was in my head. Our Lord says, whoever wants to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for me will find it. Could there be a more complete human expression of this most profound spiritual paradox than in that of Christian marriage? It is for this reason that the Apostle Paul lifts marriage to the position of being analogous to the profound mystery of Christ's relationship to his bride, the church. The purpose of today is to celebrate and to commemorate the decision of Eric and Wendy to be selfless unto one another, that the two might choose to give up their two-ness in order to be one, united in Christ. And in giving up themselves, first unto Christ, second unto each other, they so find themselves, their true selves, in right relationship to God and to each other. And it is for this union that our hearts are filled with joy today. That's what I thought this morning. But honestly, when I saw Eric and I saw Wendy kneel down on that cushion there before Rob and for Mr. K, I was overcome with emotion. Not just what I thought about marriage, but what I truly felt. Eric is he's a strong guy. He's got a lot of emotion, but he keeps it way down inside. And I noticed that the two of them, as they were kneeling down together, were crying, both of them, out of joy in the moment. And they were both Eric handed his handkerchief to Wendy, and Wendy held the hand of Eric. They both were overcome with emotion, and emotion welled up in me, and I'm not a crying guy, but a tear welled up in my own eye. Wendy couldn't be a more perfect girl for Eric. She's full of composure, full of grace, and except late at night, maybe. There couldn't be a more perfect match for my brother. I think I know him pretty well. I mean, all I could think of when I saw him there was our relationship and just how much I did love him, and how much I was so happy that he had found this girl, this girl that totally did complete his personality and was someone that could penetrate that strength. I mean, Eric is someone who desires love and affection more than most, but at the same time, let's just say Eric has a tough exterior. I'll finish up with the last part here. As we raise our glasses of celebration, we do not merely pour out blessing upon them, though this we may do, but we also do commit to support them both for the rest of their lives and for ours, and unto eternity in the name of Christ our Lord. To Wendy and Eric Vent, we do love you.
Thank you. Videotape.